Hello again, guys. Corey here. I'm out in Leander, Texas, another suburb of Austin. Right now, what I'm doing is I am going to stretch some carpet for a contractor buddy of mine. And my best advice to you guys is be real careful if you're a sole proprietor on what contractors you help. A lot of them love to find you and send you out and then hide from you when it comes time to pay you. Real fun. That's why they have shows called To Catch a Contractor, because there's snakes all in that business. Same way with those restoration companies, the exact same crowd. Anyway, all this advice comes to you free from 20 years of experience. Let me turn the camera around and show you what I'm doing and where I'm starting. All right, we are upstairs here, and the reason why he was here was the floor. It got a soft spot in it or something, so he tore the carpet back and he fixed it, and now I'm gonna put it all back together. I'm doing a stretch on it, but the carpet looks to be, I don't know exactly, but it looks to be the original carpet in the home, which this stuff is designed to last about 3 years. So it looks like it's got at least 15 years on it, if I had to guess. I'll try to figure out later in the video kind of how old it is. And I'm gonna clean when I can reach here too, when I get done. Anyway, right here, I'm stretching across here. Right now I'm gonna reseam that. That's gonna get probably this much cut out of it. And this carpet can be put back together right here. And this carpet is really, really concerning because of the amount of age and wear that's on it. What I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to get this one wrinkle here to pull out as well. And in order to do that, more than likely, that's gonna have to move over there because it's gonna incorporate some of that in with this. So you're gonna probably see a whole lot of stuff move over by the time I get it stretched in place. But anyway, a special thanks to Triforce. Good guys at Triforce. I'm not a dealer for Triforce. I don't get paid anything if you buy a Triforce. I just enjoy helping those guys, and that's exactly how we're gonna keep it. I'm not gonna be a dealer anymore for anybody. I'm just gonna help the people that I believe in. And if I ever find somebody, you know, that I believe in being a dealer for, then maybe. But for now and a long time to come, no more dealerships with me, none. All right, I'm gonna start my stretching and I'll check back in a bit. All right, this carpet's pretty old, so I'm gonna do a little stretching here so we can kind of see how the tool works. And I've gotta be really, really careful too. Put the crank down on it, it is probably going to rip. Thank you. there's a little bit more we gotta get right here. And this right here, man, I'm afraid. I'm really afraid, but I'm gonna try to get that. And it's in a bad spot, but let's see here. First, get this guy stretched in. My little helper. Looks like I'm gonna have to move this guy right here. I'm gonna have to move this over, a little puppy to help me, because this is gonna have to get some level of stretching here as well, it looks like. Anyway, I'll be back. All right, over here now. So let me try to cover some of this. I don't believe that ever in the history of ever have I stretched carpet that I was really scared of it ripping. You know, there's always a chance, but a high probability here. So it's one of the beauties of using the Triforce here. Barely room to fit. And you can see there's nothing but stairway behind me. So see if I can fit here between the two. Pretty difficult. So you make the stretch, hold it in place with your leg. Thank you. right, now I gotta stretch in that piece there, and still kind of got a wrinkle here, but with as much as I've got pulled right here, that should be just fine. I'm gonna stretch it over, and I'm actually, I don't think I'm gonna even use the seam stretcher on this one. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just use this guy here, the Triforce, and push it over and stay nail it. Probably what I'm gonna do, and then push that piece in, but hoping that create a buckle there. So this guy here, it's really not in the books for that to come out. I'm afraid. I'm gonna work with it a little bit. I don't think it's possible. It's better, but I don't think I can make it go away without ripping something. Anyway, I'll check back in a bit. All right, got it stretched in, and I was able to get it to basically right there. You can see where it was bunched up together under the couch. So we've got it flat, but it being tight as a banjo string is not in the cards for this guy here. So anyway, I've got this guy set up here. I'm gonna put the tape under it. And that's my little supervisor still watching right there. That's my buddy. Anyway, I'm gonna put the tape under it and put that guy back together. And then right here, take a little closer look. Got my camera on a tripod here, trying to hold it. So this is what we got here. That's what's gonna come off of that. So anyway, basically what I'm gonna do here is just, or use a row separator, separate the row here, and then weld this guy back together. And it's always a little harder when you cut through tape, but that's what you got to do here. It's old stuff too, boy. It's really old. So I'm not gonna cover any of that. I'm basically gonna just put it back together. And I show the finished product, and I'm still undecided whether or not I'm gonna clean it, because if I clean it, it's gonna look so dissimilar in all the other rooms compared to what I can do out here. I don't know. I'm gonna talk to the people here and see what they think. They're renters here, and the guy that's making the repair is working for the homeowner, which is out of country or something. So anyway, I'm gonna put it back together, and I'll be back in a bit. All right, little catch up here on the video. Obviously it'll come off right there. Got this guy seamed in here, and that's the piece that I cut out of there, right there. Still gotta trim this off here and there, seam that guy together here. And right there, I'll cut that piece off. And then we'll decide if we're gonna clean it or not. But man, if I clean it, I'm gonna title the video "Watch This" or something. It'd be a good time. As you can kind of tell the color it's supposed to be right there. That's not bleach. That's where they cleaned up a spot. So that represents basically the color of the carpet is supposed to be. Oh, and that's how you remember to do things. Right there. Can't even read it now. Did it earlier though. Anyway. All right. I'm going to get back to it, and I'll check in here in just a little bit. All right, guys. That finishes up the stretching here. So I appreciate you watching. As always, questions, let me know. 512-350-1129. I'm going to do some cleaning now. It's 15 after 9 right now. Long days here. Long days. See you in a bit. Thanks for watching. God bless.